guys. Obviously, my name is Jordan. My tournament is a wiffle ball tournament named the Iron Horse Challenge. I'll explain the name in a second, but it's in Tampa, Florida. It's a unique event. There's not many around. I actually just found out the other day that there is one in Tampa, and it was this past weekend, and I'll talk about that in a second. I had to add that in. But wiffle ball is a form of baseball. It's just played with a plastic ball and bat. The balls have six grooves on one side, and it allows for the ball to move a lot. If you get hit by it, it doesn't hit that bad. It just kind of leaves a well. The Iron Horse, it comes from Lou Gehrig, who was a career Yankee, his career was cut short by ALS, which is amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, and it's now named Lou Gehrig's disease. And all proceeds will benefit the ALS Foundation to help maybe find a cure or fund research. I picked Tampa because it's pretty much where I'm from, but the Yankees, who Lou Gehrig played for, their spring training is in Tampa, and it's the location is right by their spring training facility. And Tampa is also home of a few sports teams, so that can eventually maybe lead to guest appearances by Rays or Lightning, Buccaneers players, something. And about the disease, it's a progressive neurodegenerative disease that affects nerve cells in the brain and spinal cord. A is no, neo is muscle, trophic means nourishment, so no muscle nourishment, the muscles begin to deteriorate. You eventually, you can't eat, speak, move, and eventually you stop breathing because your muscles just stop working. Specifics, it's one day. There's four fields, approximately 120 feet from home plate to the fence. They're going to be scaled to former Major League stadiums and current Major League stadiums like Fenway Park, and I want to do a Polo Grounds, which is an old field that had crazy dimensions. But at first, I wanted to do 32 adult teams and then 16 kids teams, but I felt for the first one, that was a little steep. So as far as my budget and my plans right now, I'm going to go with 16 adult teams, 8 kid teams. The kid division is fun competitive, which means that there is a speed limit on the pitches. And it's competitive, but it's also more fun-based, obviously, in the name. Six players per team, 5 on the field, and an extra hitter. This is all laid out right here. It's 35 feet from the pitcher's mound to home plate. And these are all the positions. Pitcher's hand rule is there's no first baseman. You field the ball, you throw it to the pitcher. If the guy doesn't touch first base, by the time he catches the ball, he's out. 5-inning games, Oklahoma tiebreaker. If it goes extra innings, the team starts with a runner on second base, and they have 3 outs to get them in. And then kids also have a home run derby. It's a double elimination tournament. I made brackets for it. And then this is what I just found out about. Slam diabetes. Sam Fold is a former Tampa Bay Ray. He's last I heard, he was with the Athletics. But this tournament is fun competitive, it's adults, and he does it to research for type 1 diabetes because he is a type 1 diabetic, but this tournament includes a home run derby, a kids game, a sponsors game, and a special guest. Like, there's all sorts of big leaguers that get involved, and he has one in his home state of Vermont, and he has one in Tampa at the University of South Florida campus, and this is just a little video from this year's. That's Kevin Kiermaier for the Tampa Bay Rays. He won a Gold Glove this year, and that's a mini home run this year. The date is on Black Friday, so the way I see it is the wives are going to be out shopping and such, and then this will leave the entire day for the fathers and the sons and the maybe daughters to participate in this event. This is my organizational chart. I basically just thought about all the jobs that I needed to run this event smoothly, and I just threw in names just for why not. My logo, You actually, in order to run an official wiffle ball tournament, you have to sign up through the wiffle company. So this is their sanctioned wiffle tournament logo, and I just threw on the details. And obviously we all made waivers and such, so. Marketing. As far as strategy goes, I've tried to throw in the social media handles. I've made social media handles up to for the project's sake. But I use Facebook ad, magazine ad, since Brian said no one really uses reads magazines anymore, so I would want that to be online on a website for like a news website like Channel 13 or whatever we have in Tampa. And this is my Facebook ad. But I threw on potential sponsors. It says proceeds benefiting the ALS Foundation, the website. Magazine ad has the social media handles, the website, and a fake phone number to call. Web banner. Postcard has, once again, the social media handles, the website, and the phone number with the logo. Fun for all ages, because that's really what it's meant to be. And then the date, November 25th, 2016, which is next year's Black Friday. My potential sponsors, I pretty much just generic Publix. We have this place called PDQ, I don't know if anybody's ever heard of it, but Chipotle, Powerade. Equipment, Wiffle, obviously, because they're the name brand. Other companies that make equipment, Easton, Louisville Slugger, Yeti for coolers, for drinks. Shutt Sports, they make the bases, the throwdown bases. Apparel, Easton, Adidas, Champion. CustomInk.com is where I made all my shirts. And then alcohol, simply because it's gonna be a lot of adults there. And my ideal sponsors, Ferg's Bar and Grill is a local business that's about 20 years old. And there's one in St. Pete across the Tropicana Field and now in Tampa as well, which the my event dinner will be at. And then these are just, I chose soft tub because it's like a more refreshing type. And then Chase, Adidas, Publix, the Lightning, Buccaneers, Rays, Yankees. My sponsorship packages, I have 5 single packages available, 4 double packages available, 2 triples, 2 home runs, and 2 champion packages. Or no, 4, 3, 3. But the champion package comes with an 8-foot by 2.5 banner in the center field of 2 fields. And then there's 2 available, so 4 fields. Naming rights, other size banners are included. Champion also has a company logo front and center. Company logo on awards, company logo on t-shirts, comes on a website, and then full half and quarter page addresses the program. My budget, like I said, 16 adult teams projected, 18 kid teams projected plus 150 fans, adults $10, kids 10 and under getting free. The entry fee is $50 per person, $300 per team. Souvenir shirts, $15 for a shirt, I have 200 shirts. And I made $11,000 about last I checked. Like I said, location. Location is approximately like right here, right next to the Raymond James Stadium. The Yankees Stadium is, as you can see, right there as well. And then the map. All the parking is on each side right here. This is actually where people tailgate for NFL games. But concessions are here and here, restrooms here and here. The white portion stands, and this is like kind of like an administration area. Exits are in red along with entrances in green. And this is where all my staff will be placed. And then my tentative schedule. Like I said, the event dinner is going to be at Ferg's Live on Channel Side. And first pitch is at 9:15. Final game should be over by about 6:00.